an ADU accessory dwelling unit ordinance that will significantly reduce the permitting and regulations around ADUs. And we have a program where we'll actually pay you $40,000 if you agree in a forgivable loan, if you agree to keep that unit affordable for 20 years. So we're trying to significantly reduce the costs and make it work for people who want to pursue that option and provide that housing. I have one small addition, which would add to the number three under Supervisor Friends, which was that we would require that you display, quote, hosted rental only Santa Cruz County permit number in the text and in a photo on your listing, so as to make sure that these are for the hosted, for people who are truly hosting, and we make sure that that all the protections and good care of the neighborhood that you all talk about is ensured. So that would be added to number three if Supervisor Friend's motion goes forward. And then finally, let me just say this, and actually in my meeting with Pascal and the others from Bonnie Doon, I was struck by a tremendous opportunity. Airbnb isn't quite ready with the technology yet, but I hope that we're one of the first communities to pilot it, which is, you know, one of the challenges of our job is we hear almost daily from people who are truly struggling. Recently, I had a six-year-old girl spend her birthday in a tent in the rain, in the freezing cold, because her family lost their housing. She goes to a local school. She had to show up to school the next day, and is still trying to work her way through housing. I hear people who are senior citizens who lose their housing suddenly, and you know it takes a while to find another unit, and they can't find a unit. There's tremendous pain. And Pascal and others, to their credit, said, you know, we'd love to open up our home to a six-year-old on her birthday and figure out how to provide that housing or for other people. And Airbnb has the ability to help, you know, Santa Rosa fire victims, which is great, or they have the ability to help refugees. They don't have ability to help people within our community who need help and provide that connection. And so they're sort of, we have local people here who are willing to do it. We have a platform that is starting heading in that direction, and I'm hopeful that we can do a pilot here in this community where we can connect people who are truly in need with the people going forward.